Do you know where the Asda is in Tunstall? That was where I grew up. That is where the street was where I grew up. It was called Global Woodland Street. It was Grindley's Spot Bank opposite to us. Then we got married and went to live in Hamel Road. You didn't have locks on your doors. You didn't need them. And if, you know, someone was taken ill, there was always somebody there. Do you want the shopping doing? I'm cooking so-and-so for dinner. I'll bring you one round. And where's your dirty washing? That sort of thing. Everybody knew everybody else. It was more like a little village, two streets, but a little village. Burslem used to be a busy place because you'd got the Co-op there for starters, and you'd got Quicksave, you'd got Woolworths, you'd got a thriving indoor market. But as the pottery diminished, so did the town.
Things are changing in the Five Towns. It can't all be done in a day, but you can make pottery without smoke. And you've only got to take a walk through our warehouse to see that the stuff's as good as ever, and there's more of it.
The beginning of it all was those little stalls that sold the seconds of the pottery. Those began to disappear. And Frank's grandma, they had a crockery shop in Hamel Road, and they had to close down because of the decline in it. And I think another thing was that when China started, they brought their pottery in, which was obviously cheaper because they could produce it cheaper. But when things started to go down, people that were starting like we did, we bought our first house. But there were starting to be queues for council houses that were being built then. There were queues for them because people could afford rent, but they couldn't afford a mortgage. Having said that, the first house that we bought in Clanway Street, we paid £920 for it. Now, that particular house was sold some months ago, and it fetched £85,000. There used to be what they called the Wakes Fortnight, and that was the annual holiday. And about 65% of Stoke-on-Trent went to Blackpool for the holidays. And you saw coach loads and train loads, you know, disappearing to Blackpool. And you thought you were going to go on holiday to get away from people, and you didn't, because every street corner you met somebody from Stoke. And if you didn't know them, you knew who they were, because the first thing that happened was you'd go into a cafe or a restaurant, depending on what finances you'd got, and the first thing that a pottery person, a true pottery person, did was to turn the cup upside down and see where it was made. And so you could see all over Blackpool people going into these places and turning the cups around to see where it was made. And you could say, they used to say, he's a potter. another thing was that when it started to come in from China, you'd pick up a China cup and you'd do that. And if it was China, it had got one ping. But if it was pottery China, it had got another ping. So that you knew exactly where it had been made. And that was how the pottery people could tell imports that were trying to be passed off as our local produce, because they hadn't got the ping that the local pottery had got. And I think the one main thing that I remember more than anything was at the end of the war, the street party we had at the end of the war. And in the street, we got the old-fashioned air raid shelters built. They were safe. And when it was raining when we were young, we used to use them as gang huts. So whatever there was that was going, you didn't need money. You made your own fun and it was free. I can remember having ration books. My father's eldest sister, she lived in Pool Fields, and she got two or three hens. So we were the bee's knees of our street because we had a regular supply of eggs. But it wasn't just our house. Whatever we had was shared amongst the street. Everybody had a bit of it.